In this video, let's do something similar to a VLOOKUP using a script. For this example, we got this data. And for each salesperson in this rates worksheet, in this table, we get some sort of commission rate. So what we want to do, we want to go find the appropriate commission rate for now, just for the first person, for Isabella in this rates table. So that should return this particular percentage. And then once we do the first one, we'll also do a script to do it for the whole thing, for the whole column. Now you could obviously do this with VLOOKUP function, but we're gonna do this specifically with a script. So what I'll do, I'll go under extensions and do app script. And this is pretty much where we're gonna do what we need to do. So the first thing we're going to need is to store some references to our both worksheets. One of them is called sales data right here, and the other one is called rates. Let's go ahead and start with this. So I'll start by creating a constant to hold the whole spreadsheet. I'll continue that by doing a worksheet for our first tab that's called sales data. And for that, we'll get that worksheet by its name, which is this. And similar to this, we need our rates worksheet, which I believe was called rates. Let's just make sure that's actually accurate. There it is. Yes. Let's rename this function. It's up to you what you want to call that. So now let's go get our data in that rates worksheet. So I'm going to basically get this range of data. And for that, we'll take that worksheet rates and do get range. Start from the second row, first column. So second row, first column, that would be the cell with Isabella. And we need to do this entire range like this. So that would be 8 rows and 3 columns going this way. And for rows, we'll get it dynamically by getting the row number 9 minus 1 to get that 8 out of this. So we'll do WS rates, get last row, -1. And for columns, we'll do 3 columns. So at this point, to get the actual data, we'll do get values to get that data to an array like this. So at this point, this rates data should be an array with this data in it. So now let's try to find one of these people in this table to see if it works. So for example, let's try to search Jose, and that should return this commission rate. So for now, I'll just say search value equals that person. Later, this search value will replace it at some point, but for now, that's good enough. So now in that rates data, I'm going to use this method find. And this is gonna accept a callback. So the callback is gonna accept each row from that table. So I'll just call it R. And for each row in that table, we have to match some sort of data. So from our row, I wanna search and find this Jose, this person, in this first column. So the first column in our array would be column number 0. Therefore, I'll do R0 to find in the first column. If you wanted to search and find that person's name in the second column, you would do 1. Now I'm gonna do 0 here, and I'm gonna check if that equals this. And for that, I'll just pass this search value variable. So what should happen with this? It should basically just find the first match for Jose, which is this one. And when it does find it, it's going to return this entire row of data. So let's try to save that in a variable for the time being. And let's try to console log to see what that looks like before we get to the rest of this. So I'm going to save this, console log this variable match row, and I'm going to make sure I have the right function here, which is this one, and I'm going to run this. Now, if you never ran a script before in this particular file, it's going to ask you for permissions. So you want to go ahead and make sure you give those permissions. In my case, I did run scripts in this file before, so it just runs right away. So you can see when I did this, I got this row back, which is that data for Jose. Now, let's try to see what happens if we search for somebody that's not in that table. Let's just add something here and rerun this. And see, when I do that, now we get undefined. So if we don't get a match, then what we're going to get is undefined here. And if we do get the match, it's going to give us the whole row. I'm going to get this back to Jose. Now, at this point, if I run this, that's going to be this, right? Now, we want this percentage right here, which is column number 3 in this array, which would be 0, 1, 2, because arrays start from 0. So if I do match row 2, that should just give me the percentage without the rest of the data. And there it is. That's the match. Let's go and make sure Jose's percentage is actually this 1.5 something. And there it is. It's just formatted differently. But if you look up here, you'll see it's the same number. So I'm going to go back, close this. Now, one thing I want to do, if I don't find a match, I want to right now return a blank. Right now, if we don't find a match, like for example, if I had a letter here and rerun this, see, I'm going to get this error because we're trying to get that data from the column, but there is no data. There is nothing returned. And for that reason, I can do an if statement. I can say const match. And basically, I'll say if that match row exists, then we want to do this. Otherwise, we're just going to return a blank, which you can do double quotes. You can also do null. That should be fine too. So at this point, if I try to run this and return this match, see, it returns null. You could also do double quotes. And then finally, if I turn this to something that actually exists and rerun this, it will return that percentage. And this now will be our match. So I was able to get this for a single value. And if I wanted to place that in here, for here, we would probably want to do Isabella. So let's just quickly replace that with Isabella right here. And if I run this, you'll see that it's going to change the percentage to Isabella's percentage. But now if I wanted to actually place that value here in this cell, in this H2 cell, in the sales data worksheet, then I would do this WS sales data, get range, and then use that cell, which is this H2. I could do H2, or I can also do row column. Right now, I'll just do this. And then I can do set value because we just have a single value and just make it the match. Like this. So at this point, if I run this, we should be able to see that we placed that value here. Now, this is not formatted as a percentage, but the value ends up being here. Okay, great. Now, finally, maybe we'll also modify to grab what we're searching from this cell, C2, instead of just hard coding it. So for that reason, instead of doing this, we can do that same sales data, get range, and then grab from that cell, which right now is C2. So I'll just go ahead and do that. And then in this case, we're going to get that value instead of setting. And that should get that value from that cell. And then we're going to search for it. We're going to find it in that other table and then return the match. Let's just comment this line, the console log, and see there's nothing here. So at this point, if I rerun this code, it should go find the match for Isabella and return the rate here, coming from this table. Okay, so now that we got this, now let's try to do this for this whole column. So for that, instead of getting this one value and placing it in this cell, we want to get this whole column of values right here. You could get this in different ways, and I've done a lot of videos to find the last row and all of that. I just did it, as a matter of fact, in that rates table too. But in this one, I'm going to keep it simple. I'm just going to write the range from C2 up to whatever the last row was, which was like C2041. So let's go ahead and do that. So what I'll do here, I'll make a little change. I'll go here and do C2041. I hope I remember that correctly. And right now, because it's a whole range instead of a single cell, I'm going to switch this to get values instead of get value. Now this will be an array. So I'll change it to search values. And now what's going to happen is this is a whole array coming from here. And we need to search every single thing in that array. And the way we can do that, we can take the search values array and we can just map through that array. And for each row in that array, we're going to do some calculations here. Now, each row would refer to one of these lines. Now, even though it's just one column, it's still going to come back as a whole row. So we need to still say the first column within the row that we just got here. So that's going to be 0. So if we wanted to refer to that person's name, that would be R0, which would be basically this search value that we're trying to find. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to take a couple of lines here, these two, and I'm going to move them within this loop in this map. And here, instead of search value, I just have to use this. Now, the problem is that I already have this R variable here, so now I have a conflict. So I want to make sure I rename this variable for this loop something else. So I'll just do search row instead of row. And then we can refer to that as search row 0 for the first column in that. And that means now I can grab this and place this here as the search value itself. So now we'll search for that value within that row in that rates table. We'll find the row information, and then if there is a match, we'll basically return the match. If there is no match, we'll do null. So all we have to do at this point is simply just return those results so we can basically output that. So when you do map, it's going to return a similar size array. And that works excellent for us because if this column has 1,000 rows, then we need to return 1,000 rates. So we need the same size results. So all we need to do is just make sure we save this result in a variable. So we'll just call it matching rates, like this. And the last thing we have to do here, let's actually comment this line out for a second and run this and actually see what console log returns. So I can explain you what I'm changing here in this next step. So I'm going to go ahead and save this, rerun this. And as you can see, what I get is a whole array of matches, basically all the rates starting from first row and then second, third, and so on. Now, the problem is because I want to basically grab that information and put it here in my spreadsheet, the spreadsheet has to be in format of rows and columns, but right now this is just a single dimensional array. So it's just comma separated values here. What we need to do, we need to place each one of these in an array like a structure so that it becomes row and column. And for that, when we do this return over here, we'll just return this as an array here and here. And right now, if I show you what happens, if I just rerun this code, you'll see that it still returns the same results, only now it's in the structure of we have this array of rows, and each one has this kind of column-like structure in it. So now we should be able to put this back in the spreadsheet because it's in the format that our spreadsheet needs it. So all I have to do now is go to this sales data worksheet, grab the range where I need the results. So that's going to be from H2 through H, same row here, 2041. And that's basically starting from here all the way down until the last row here. And now instead of set value, we're going to do set values because it's a whole range of data. And we'll just take this matching rates and basically place it here. So I'm going to go ahead and comment this line, save it, and we'll rerun this to see what it looks like. Let's actually just format this column H really quickly so that it looks pretty like that. So now it's looking like percentages. Let's go back now and rerun this thing and see what happens. So I'm going to go ahead and run that. So done. I'm going to go back and take a look. And as you can see, we got our values here. So let's just check a few of those to make sure this is actually accurate. For Olivia, that's 8.62. Let's go check it out. Olivia, 8.62. That's accurate. Let's check for Jennifer as well, 9.64. So Jennifer, that's correct. Let's check one more. That should be good enough. Let's do something like Grace. That's fine. 3.19. So let's go check it out. Grace, 3.19. As you can see, it works as it should. And we did our VLOOKUP with a code. There is no function here. And there you go. That's how you do a VLOOKUP with a script. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe. And I'll see you in the next video.